Okay, as I mentioned before, I got turtles coming out of my ass, so at least for this foreseeable future, I hope this is the last turtle that I review. And it's fitting that it's Michelangelo because I've always been a really big fan of this turtle. So what's up everybody and welcome to another edition of AGR's Pop Culture Reviews. Actually guys, I'm so sorry, I have to amend that. In looking at my review schedule, it looks like the final turtle that I have to review is Raphael's Mondo figure, so we still got one more to go. So just a really quick recap guys, if you want to check out my other videos, I've completed all four turtles for the Dream X line, I'm about to complete all four turtles for the NECA line, and the final turtle that I'm going to review is for the Mondo line, which will be the Raphael figure. So those reviews are already up, so I encourage you to check them out if you want to decide whether or not you want to get all of these turtles or if you're satisfied with just one line. It's up to you guys, but the reviews are there. And I also have to mention, I did a comparison video with all three lines by one of my YouTube subscribers, Ibaiwina, so that if you want to see what the differences are between all of them, you can check out that video as well. It's pretty interesting, and I got a lot of good feedback from that video, and people made their decisions based off of it. So, having said all that, today we're going to be taking a look at NECA's final turtle, the 1/4 scale Michelangelo figure, which is freaking awesome. Now, you guys all know that I have loved the 1990 film, and I didn't realize how important that film was. You know, it was interesting because at the time, and now reflecting back, I didn't know who they were quite marketing this film to. I mean, sure, it had something for kids, but it also had something for adults. So it was in that kind of Goldilocks zone of kind of the transitioning between maturity for us teenagers. Now, the funny thing is that NECA had really been a company not known to me in terms of the figures that they used to make, which just sounds kind of crazy right now, but they are so impressive. I mean, this head sculpt looks absolutely amazing, and I've said this before, this looks like a museum piece and really looks like it came right off of the film. Now, don't freak out about the eyes, that's just the lighting. The eyes are done very well here, and this is a perfect recreation. It looks amazing, the sculpt looks great, I love the head, even the little teeth, which kind of look like chiclets, look nice, but very well done. Now, in terms of the body, it may seem like they're just copied and pasted with the other turtles, but if you're really looking closely, and I'm sure as collectors you are, you'll notice subtle differences in not only the skin tone, but also some of the musculature, particularly where you see the veins. But overall, it does look really well, and very unique I might add, especially in the chest area. I'm always so impressed with these figures because they look so lifelike. This is a really well done job by NECA, and you know what, for this price point, it's still pretty remarkable. The midsection of this piece, just like the rest of the figures, are incredibly detailed. I'm always very impressed with the leather strapping here, even though I know it may not be actual leather, it might be a faux leather, there's still a lot of detail here, especially in the little buttons and stuff like that. It's pretty well done. You know, I gotta commend NECA because they are really spared no expense in terms of the overall detail with these figures. Now guys, easily one of the coolest things about this figure is definitely the little accessory that they give. They give you a bag of pork rinds, guys. You remember in the film when Mikey asked Donatello if he wants a pork rind? Yeah, they give you the bag. It's so freaking cool, and it's really lifelike. It looks like an actual bag of pork rinds. This is freaking awesome. I'm so glad that they included this. The other thing that impressed me about this accessory is that it looks like NECA finally listened to the fans, and they made a dedicated hand just for this bag, so it doesn't flop around, and you can actually pose it with it. Now, the nunchucks here are kind of a little bit weird to me. Now, they don't look bad, and they use premium material because it's an actual wood that they use. What I don't like is the string that ties them together. I wish they would have used a little bit higher end material there. It's not like they're cheap, there's no worry about them breaking, but it just looks like it's like twine or something holding it together. And I don't know, it's kind of throwing it off. I know in the film they used whatever resources they had available in the sewer to make their weapons, and even if NECA was just trying to stay true to what they used in the original film, it's just a little weird looking. Now, I don't know if this is just my own impression of this figure, but this one felt a lot more solid than the rest of the figures, and that's saying a lot because the rest of them felt like a tank when I pulled them out of the box. I also have to say that Michelangelo's legs look a little bit more muscular than the rest of the figures, especially in the shading. They really emphasize those cuts in the quad muscles. I noticed that almost immediately. He looks like a freaking Battletoad. But if you ever play that game, you'll know what I'm talking about. And what can I say about these turtle shells, guys? They look absolutely magnificent. Now, admittedly, not as detailed and realistic looking as the Dream X line, but this is a second runner-up, and they look amazing, especially in the overall detail, the shading, and the patterns look really great. And of course, we can't forget adding to the extra realism of this figure is definitely the mixed media that they use. The bandana looks absolutely fantastic because it is made of fabric, and it really matches the front part of his bandana perfectly. Great job again. Now, with Michelangelo, you don't get that extra canister of mutagen, which, you know, if you already got the other turtles, it's no big deal, because you've already got three sets, essentially. But you do get six additional hands for various poses, and you get a pizza slice, so, you know, basically, you've got a bunch of extra accessories lying around with these turtles. Overall, guys, this is another magnificent piece from NECA. This Michelangelo figure is really cool. And if you have the entire set, guys, I guarantee you, once you put them all together, they're gonna look absolutely fantastic. And here's the good news, guys. If you're interested in completing your set, both Leonardo, Raphael, and Michelangelo are up for sale now at the regular retail price. And it looks like Donatello is getting a reissue, and it's up for pre-order now at Big Bad Toy Store. Now, before I go, I just want to send a special shout out to the folks over at NECA and Big Bad Toy Stores for sending this wonderful piece over for review. And if you're interested in this and other collectibles, please visit www.bigbadtoystore.com. Alright everybody, so that's my official review on NECA's quarter scale Michelangelo figure from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 1990 film. As always, I thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next AGR's Pop Culture Reviews. Pork rind, pork rind. Confucius say forgiveness is divine, but never pay full price for late pizza.
Stand for what you believe in and find the strength to do what's right. That's turtle power. Turtles on a half shell, they're on a mission. When there's a battle, got the enemy wishing that they stayed at home. Instead of fighting these ninja masters with moves like lightning, they were once normal, but now the mutants. Splinter's the teacher, so they are the students. Leonardo, Michelangelo, and Donatello make up the team with one other fellow, Raphael. He's the leader of the group, transformed from the norm by the nuclear goo. Pizza's the food that's sure to please. These ninjas are into pepperoni and cheese. Back to the story, it's not hard to find. Ninjas not just of the body, but of the mind. Those were the words that the master instructed, but a letter from Shredder had splintered up.